Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we're going to be creating retro logo batch design inside Illustrator. In this tutorial, we'll look at how you can create a classic looking logo batch. By using different shapes, you can give unique look to each design. For this tutorial, I'll use two different color tones for the design. During the process, I'll be using some vector sources from vixel.com. You can also check out any of your favorite website where you can find vector stocks. Under Vixel, you can download the vectors in several formats. They are also offering monthly subscription starting at $9.99 with licenses for every download. They are also offering merchandise licenses so that anyone can create design with their resources and sell them. So let's begin with the designing process. First, we'll create out the base of the logo. So select the ellipse tool and draw out a circle. Give it a stroke color and increase the thickness to around 26 points. Next, we'll create the rectangular shape. So select the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle. Switch the color from stroke to fill. Then using the pen tool, add one anchor points at the middle of the top edge and the bottom edge. Now using die selection tool, select both the middle anchor points. Then using transform tool, increase the height with the shift pressed. This will transform only the middle region. Now using the die selection tool, click and drag the circular icon inward to make the corners round. Next, we'll add the edge thickness. So select this shape and create a copy on top using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Now select the top shape and give it a stroke thickness. So we'll change the color to something different and set the stroke thickness to 5 points. Now go to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. Then go to Pathfinder and click on minus front option to subtract the edge thickness. Now give it a stroke thickness around 2 point and change the color to white. After this, let's reposition the shape according to our design. Do some adjustments with the size and thickness. Use the rulers to set the exact position. Once you are done with the adjustments, let's type our text for the design. Press T for the text tool and type out Caribbean. Apply white color and increase the size. To remove the spacing between each alphabet, go to Character and reduce the value to 0. Now let's choose a suitable font for the text. We'll apply Baskerville Old Face font. Scale up the size and place it in the center. Next, we'll give an arc curve to the text. To do that, go to Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Wrap. Here, you'll get different styles of distortion. We'll choose Arc Lower and keep it horizontal. Set the blend percent to around -18% and click OK. Now extend the lower region using the selection tool. Next, double click on the text, then add a stroke thickness and change the color to white. Now double click outside and we got a broader text. Let's apply proper color to the text. We'll give light brown color. So double click on the fill color to open the color picker panel. Choose light brown color or you can use the color code #E8DBD4 and click OK. Apply the same color to the stroke thickness as well. Next, type our text CSEA and increase the spacing between each of the alphabet. For this, apply the same color and place it below the Caribbean text. Now select the line segment tool and draw out a horizontal line. Give it a stroke thickness around 5 points. And under stroke panel, change the profile to triangular shape. This will give a pointed effect to the line segment. Create a duplicate of the line with the alt pressed and for this, flip the direction by clicking on this option. Next, we'll type our text logo batch in circular path. To do that, select the lower circle and create under duplicate on top. Use the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Now go to text and choose type on a path tool. Then click on the circular path. change the fill color to white, and type out logo badge. Click and drag this line to set the position. And click and drag the middle line to flip the text. Now select all the text and change the font to Agency FB Bold Font. Now edges the lines to balance it in the middle. After that, scale up the size to place it at the center of the stroke. Next, we'll give light brown color to the center of the circle. So let's create another duplicate of the circle. Scale up the size according to the inner ring and fill it out with light brown color. We'll create another duplicate of the circle. For this, apply the same color and switch it to stroke. Then bring out a ruler and place it around here. Now, using the scissor tool, give one cut here and the other over here. After that, delete out the lower curve. Now select the curve, then go to stroke and choose round cap. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is to add the shape vector. As we are designing a logo for the Caribbean Sea, we need to look up for the vectors related to our theme. So now, I'll go to Vixel and look up for the vectors. Let's search for pirate ship and let's download this vector in SVG format. I will also need a flat wheel vectors, so let's look up for it and download it. Now let's open our downloaded vectors. Open the pirate ship folder and open the Illustrator file. This will open in Illustrator. We need to do some modification with the vector. So select and drag and drop it to our main document. Scale down the size and place it here. Let's reduce the stroke thickness to around 0.75 points. This will give a decent outline to your design. Now with the Alt pressed, click and drag to create a duplicate. We'll use one of the duplicates for outlines and the other one for fill color. Select the first one. Then using the Shape Builder tool, click and drag to combine the shapes. Combine the small circles and the top region too. In the same way, we'll combine all the small divisions to make it into one piece. Select the fill color so that you can apply color while applying Shape Builder tool. Do the same for all the other cloth pieces. We can also call it sails. Remove all the unwanted pieces in the middle. After that, click on each of the boxes to make it a separate shape. Continue extracting the shape by clicking on each of the details. Once you are done, let's delete out all the unwanted curves. Delete out all the tiny curves. Also delete this pointed shape as well. Now select the other shape and remove the fill color. You can see some extra strokes. So double click and select the individual strokes and delete it out. Also, let's delete out the back sail. Now select the outline shape and place it over the fill shape. Make sure it is placed overlapping the strokes. Now let's change the stroke color. So double click to open the color pick panel. Let's apply gray color. We'll use the color code #A8A4A1. Now select the fill shape and remove the stroke color. Then double click and select the back sail and give it a stroke color using the same color code. Also, set the stroke thickness to 0.75 points. Next, select the fill shape and apply black color. This way, we got a vector shape in black color with gray outlines. We can easily change the color anytime. Now continue tweaking the shapes. Delete out the unwanted details. Next, double click and select these two strokes and increase the stroke thickness to 1 point. After that, using the Width tool, click and drag to increase the width of the stroke. Do the same for the second stroke. Click and drag where you want to give broader width to give a dynamic look and narrow it down for thin strokes. Once you are done, select all the small strokes and apply a triangular profile under stroke panel. Flip it in order to give a correct direction. Increase the thickness to 1 point and change the cap to flat cap. Next, we'll separate the waves from the main design. So double click inside and select all the curves. Then group it up using the shortcut Command or Control G. And then press Command or Control X to cut, double click outside and paste it using the shortcut Command or Control V. This way the water waves are in separate layer. Let's change the stroke color to black and under stroke panel, choose profile 1 to give a pointed ends. After that, increase the thickness to 1 point. Now place it on the back side of the ship. Let's do some adjustments. Select the top curves and scale up the size. Place it little upward. Then using a die selection tool, edit the anchor points exceeding the outlines of the ship. Now click and drag to select all the vectors and place it over the logo. Place it in the middle. We got this circle on top. So let's place it on the last layer. Then arrange it to back. This way, we got the waves on top. Now using the pen tool, extend the curves to make it into fill object. Use the width tool to increase the stroke width. After that, apply light gray color to the fill object. You can use this color code. Next, let's bring in our second vector, the flat wheel. Open it in Illustrator, then drag and drop it to our main document. Scale on the size and place it just above the logo wedge text. Do the proper placement using the ruler. Lastly, we'll do some final adjustments. We'll add a drop shadow effect to the text. So create a duplicate of the Caribbean text. Fill it up with dark gray color for fill and the stroke. Then place it back to its original position. And move it a little bit downward. And we got a nice retro logo badge. To give a red border to the logo, create under duplicate of the logo. Select the circle and change the stroke color to dark red. After that, create a copy on top and change it to outline stroke. This will convert into fill object. Give a stroke thickness around 5 points. And then again convert it into outline stroke. After that, using the shape builder tool, extract the two circles and apply black color to the inner circle and white color to the outer circle. Add a nice black background and we got a nice logo badge in two different colors. Finally, our logo is ready. The designing process was very simple. By using the ready-made graphic resources, we have saved up lots of our time. I hope you like the techniques and enjoy the tutorial. To check out various graphic design bundles provided by Vixel, you can go and check out their website or you can find the link in the description. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.